financing works, how you should utilize it, and what are some best practices to make sure you get into the best terms possible. All right, so let's talk about how it works. If you want a business and you're looking to buy a truck, you're looking to buy a milling machine, a ditch witch, any type of equipment, all right, you want to use equipment financing. Why? Because it's going to allow you to purchase that now with little to zero money out of pocket, and you can finance it over the next 3 to 6 years. All right. Why is this beneficial? Why would you use equipment financing instead of paying cash? Well, first off, cash is always going to be king. All right. So you want to conserve your cash for other growth items like marketing, all right, or inventory, or adding to your team. Next, when you use equipment financing, you can write off the interest, all right, and it helps your cash flow because it's a lower monthly payment over the course of time, all right. And next, you know, not just writing off the interest, but if you do, let's say, a lease to own or a lease with a dollar buyout, you can actually write off the whole lease payment. And depending on how heavy the equipment is, if check with your accountant, but you can actually write off the entire cost of year one, depending on the size and the weight of that equipment. All right, so those are all advantages, whether it's cash flow or taxes. That's why you should use equipment financing over paying cash. All right, next, when you utilize equipment financing, it helps you build comparable debt. That shows that you can service a payment for equipment, and then next time you need to get equipment, you can actually qualify for a lot more. Because one, hopefully that equipment is helping your business grow. And then two, you've shown, once you make 12 payments, 12 monthly payments on it, that you're a responsible borrower, and you should at least be able to qualify for twice your comparable debt, right? So if you bought a $100,000 piece of equipment today, in a year from now, you should at least qualify for $200,000 in equipment financing, as long as everything's remaining the same. Right? These are all important tools and aspects of growing your business. Now, how does it work with new equipment versus financing old equipment? The new equipment, you're just going to go to the dealership or the vendor or the distributor and get an invoice. The invoice is made out to your business with the business address on it. It has the year, make, model, everything that you need, and the purchase price. All right, we use that to underwrite, you know, the transaction. If it's used, you're going to need a purchase and sale with, again, year, make, model, maybe a condition report, how many hours or how many miles are on it, and then you're going to need the front and back of the title. All right. Once you have all those things, you can typically just fill out a one-page application, 6 months of banks, a tax return. If it's a larger piece, you may need financials. And the good thing about equipment financing is it only takes, 24 to 48 hours to get approved. And then the whole transaction gets wrapped up in a couple hours after that. So it is a quick and easier process, and it does help you build your business credit. In addition to helping build your business credit, you're building comparable debt, and you're helping out your cash flow. So it is really a wise decision to utilize equipment financing. If you have any questions about equipment financing or anything else, please reach out to me.